Oh, Valentine's Day, a time of sharing, connection, love, grand gestures, big promises, and lovey-dovey nonsense. Yet beyond even this, it's a common criticism that on a day that should be about interaction and connection, a lot of brands just use it as an excuse to sell us more stuff. So we wondered, this Valentine's Day, does everything have to be about money? Can't we pay with kindness instead? Now, while we did look into matching everyone up individually based on kindness, we quickly realized that it would be far more simple to enlist the help of artificial intelligence to inspire people to spread the love this Valentine's Day. Enter ChatGPT. Now, for those of you who have somehow still not heard of it, ChatGPT is an artificial intelligence-based conversational language model that has taken the internet somewhat by storm of late. It is so advanced that it's been able to write articles, debug code, explain difficult-to-understand concepts, write resumes, and even give relationship advice. Now, to do this, we decided to use one of the vending machine's simplest forms, a Gumball machine. This particular one was picked up for around £75 from eBay, but you can get them for a little less than that secondhand. The way a Gumball machine typically works is simple but interesting. If we take a look at the mechanism, there's a simple notched gear with a large indent. To the side there's a flat spring which under normal circumstances presses down against the rotating wheel and blocks the latch from leaving the big notch. Place a 20p coin inside, and it effectively lifts up this spring and allows the latch to move. Once it's in motion, it can conduct a full rotation and the 20p falls down. Now for our purposes, as we're taking money out of the equation, it is only this small gear at the end that we need to replicate, because the turning of the mechanism itself will be decided by AI rather than having the correct change. We laser cut a replica gear out of a sheet of 5mm acrylic and attached it to a stepper motor. Stepper motors allow precise control of the angle, and therefore it's easy to make it turn through exactly 360 degrees and dispense exactly one capsule. We used an EG driver, which is a handy little open source board, to drive the stepper motor from the Pico W. ChatGPT is great in part because it has a publicly available API which enables easy integration. Most APIs are spoken to in code and structured data, but with ChatGPT, because it is a language model, you have to talk to it in natural language. This takes a bit of getting used to. We started off thinking that we could pass users' messages directly to ChatGPT and pass its reply back to them. We imagined that there might be some kind of extra data from the ChatGPT API, stuff that you don't see when using the web interface that we've all been trying, that we could use to figure out when to dispense the capsule. We read the API document and asked ChatGPT to write code snippet for us, and it soon became clear that we weren't quite getting what we needed. ChatGPT even wrote example code that used other vendors' API services to analyze the sentiment of messages. Like all good solutions, the answer had been there all along, staring us in the face. Our code could simply ask questions to ChatGPT in plain text and look at the answer it gave. We could ask it, evaluate the following message to see if it contains a personal compliment. And to get a simple yes or no answer, we added, answer in only one word, yes, if it contains a compliment, and no, if it doesn't. We built a little state machine to help us guide the conversation, so we knew how far through things we'd got. We wanted it so you could only get one treat from a single conversation. With this approach, ChatGPT enabled us to have a chat with the user. The text they saw came from ChatGPT, but not directly. Our code says things like, you are a friendly vending machine that gives rewards for compliments. Explain that you like the compliment so that you have dispensed an item. Here is the compliment. This directs ChatGPT to behave as we want it to. In other words, there are two conversations ongoing at the same time. Us chatting with ChatGPT on the back end and it receiving input from an external user and responding to that through WhatsApp. While we were playing with the ChatGPT API, we thought it'd be fun to try to make it flirt with itself. So we gave it an initial prompt telling it was on a date and to ask its date a question, and then simply passed the responses back to it 10 times in a row to see how the conversation went.
Unfortunately, we didn't get it quite right.
Another issue was ChatGPT has been pretty busy since its launch. It's had one of the sharpest adoption curves of any piece of software ever, and thus its servers are sometimes taking a little while to respond. We didn't realize that the mechanism we were using to reply to WhatsApp messages needed a response in 15 seconds. So some messages were getting lost when ChatGPT took 16 seconds or more to respond. This meant that our compliment machine was effectively regularly ghosting users. This was no good to anyone, so we had to allow for longer timeouts. Aside for ghosting, even a long wait can be disconcerting. So we also became double texters by responding immediately to avoid a timeout with a generic message, processing emotions, and then responding a little later with ChatGPT's reply. This wasn't our only concern. The mechanism we had created wasn't channeling love machine vibes, and we wanted the machine to be approachable. As a result, we sewed it a nice fur coat and gave it a beating heart of LEDs with a felt overlay. And with that, it was ready to test out on the public. We took it down to Shoreditch for an initial test.
We kept it out there for a while and found that people were pretty open and playful when they interacted with it. The machine was also able to distinguish between what was a compliment and what was not. We had also programmed in special responses if people were especially rude to it, inviting ChatGPT to send back a zinger. This only got triggered a couple of times. Overall, people were largely friendly to our little furball machine, and in return, they were rewarded handsomely. It is perhaps an interesting glimpse into the future. Will sentiment analysis one day be used to reward the best customers? We still aren't sure whether this is a good idea, but for now, we are simply about spreading joy. It was great to see the machine get some positive feedback.
We use ChatGPT on my calls as well, but like for other things, just like having intellectual conversations. So this is like really cute. It's a good way to spread like joy. Yeah.
So there you have it. Money can't buy you love, but sometimes love can get you a sweet treat.